Lisa here. Well, why are 800,000 people planning to leave both New York and California? Probably because the lame, crazy Democratic laws and rules and regulations that are pushed on the heads of all the citizens of those two states. Well, now mainstream media is actually forced to admit it. At least they're forced to admit it to a level. And I'm going to show you the report in a moment. But hey, let's just be frank here. Everybody knows that the housing costs in both New York and California are over the roof. They're out the door. They're insane. People can't afford to live there. They also know that the rules, their gun laws in both of those states are absolutely absurd. And people are starting to wake up to the fact that they want their freedom. They want their freedom to have their gun rights. Not only that, but in both of these states, we also have a rise in crime and also a rise in race wars, probably because the Democratic Party has heavily pushed this race war idea, especially during the Trump administration. So lots of things going on, but the article I have to show you is actually from CNBC, a fake news network, if you will. So before I show it to you, what I want to say is this: they paint it first from a conservative point of view, and then they attack that conservative. When all reality, the truth is, people are leaving California and New York, and they're forced to admit it in some way, shape, or form. But check out this report. It's from CNBC.com, and the title of it reads, 800,000 people are about to flee New York and California because of taxes, says economist. Now it goes on in the subtitle to read, 800,000 people will leave New York and California over the next 3 years due to a new tax bill, conservative economists Arthur Laffer and Stephen Moore said in an op-ed in the Wall Street Journal. Other economists dispute this finding, say there is no connection between taxes and migration. The economists claim high tax states will likely generate more wealth than they lose. So there it is. As you can see, the writer of that report specifically attempts to turn it and say, nah, that's just what conservatives believe. But in reality, people already have started leaving New York. Check out this report from last year. I'm just going to toss it up on the screen real quick, but you can see many people have exited and are leaving New York. Now, that article was back in 2017. Think the pattern is still continuing? It's not just about tax laws and rules. It's about what is going on in those two states. They're highly Democratic and highly blue. And in all reality, blue states are starting to migrate to red states. This is something that's been happening even more so just this past year because people are tired of the Democratic laws. But the problem is they are bringing their mental ideas into the Republican states, and this could cause major issues, causing red states to go blue, which is what we've seen happening or almost happened in the state of Arizona, my state here, which I am fighting to the brim because we have lots of people migrating in from California, but bringing in their liberal ideas, not understanding that that's exactly what destroyed their own state, is that liberal mentality and the liberal ideas and the progressive ideas that they push in California. They're forcing our way, and it's just gonna make us another California. And that's something that I'm trying to fight here on my channel. So I wanted to bring you the up-to-date information on what's going on with that and keep you in the loop on all those things. And just a heads up, if you meet people and you live in those states and they come from those areas, educate them. Educate them on why our system is different from their system. What caused them to leave that area? Or and a lot of the times you also have heavy Republicans or heavy conservatives that are leaving those areas in order to come to a better place. And they're already educated, as many of you are. But the more that we can win over to our side, the better. The more that we can wake up to the liberal progressive side, because let's be frank, the Democrat and Republican parties are dead. They don't exist. They're not there. The Democratic Party has become the progressive, leftist, socialist, communist, that's what it is, party. There is no Democratic Party. There is no more Republican Party. They have all kind of, the Republican Party has somewhat become the Democratic Party from back in the day, and now you have a conservative kind of party, if you will. Anyhow, I'd love to get your feedback on all of that. Please don't forget to check out my channel and my partners here at noblegoldinvestment.com. And don't forget to subscribe. Subscribe to my backup channel, Lisa Haven Vlogs, because you never know what's going to happen, so make sure you subscribe to that one as well. Well, I'm Lisa Haven, signing out.